MCoCal, serving breeders and growers around the world through plant variety management.
Hello, I'm Chad Finn with the U.S. Department of Agriculture, Agricultural Research Service, based in Corvallis, Oregon at the Horticultural Crops Research Unit. We develop blackberries there as one of our big parts of our breeding programs, and the program has been going on since 1928, so it's a very long-lived program. Today we're going to look at Hall's Beauty. Hall's Beauty is one of our new releases. It's very exciting because it's not only thornless, but very high yielding, early ripening, and it has a very uniform, firm berry that's very sweet. Everybody likes to eat Hall's Beauty, and it works well both for local sales, fresh market, as well as machine harvesting. It's not a giant fruit, like our Columbia Giant. It's sort of a medium-sized fruit, but very attractive size. Typically, you know, 6 to 8 gram fruit. It's firm, it's got good tough skin. Its skin does not really bleed. It holds very nicely. This one will go through the machine without bleeding, as well as it can be hand-picked for a fresh product very nicely. The fruit are uniformly shaped, good black color, and they have a nice gloss to them. When you eat the berries, they're very sweet, and really anybody who's ever tried Hall's Beauty likes Hall's Beauty because it's got a good acid-sweet balance, but it certainly favors the sweetness. Hall's Beauty machine harvests very nicely and makes a really nice product for IQF fruit, individually quick frozen fruit, puree, or juice. A couple of the other interesting things about Hall's Beauty, in addition to its high yield and thornlessness and flavor, it seems to have some adaptation to wet sites. So in areas where varieties are not doing well because it's a little too wet, this may be a great alternative. Hall's Beauty is a trailing blackbird. Here on our farm, we've trained the new primacanes down. We have the floricanes up high. At the end of the season, we'll remove those floricanes and then train those new canes up onto the wire. Another way that our growers are increasingly doing it is they're taking those new primacanes and training them right through the fruiting canes. It really cuts down on your management costs and makes it much more affordable to train. But we have yet to see any significant disease problems with this practice. Where can you grow these? Well, certainly wherever you've grown Marion or Boysen or Black Diamond, these should be well adapted. That's typically the Pacific Northwest, California, and other climates where it's sort of Mediterranean, fairly mild winters, fairly mild summers. In those kinds of environments, they thrive. So why should you grow Hall's Beauty? Certainly, it's thornless, early, firm berry, tough skin, machine harvestable, all those things which make it a very good processing berry that also in bloom looks spectacular in your backyard.